SHAKTI project is building a family of 6 processors based on the RISC-V instruction set architecture ISA. REMO is the code name of the SHAKTI C-class based SoC that was taped out at Semiconductor Laboratory SCL Chandigarh. The features of the core are in order 5-stage 64-bit microcontroller supporting the entire stable RISC-V ISA RV64IMAFD. Compatible with latest privilege spec, version 1.21 of RISC-V ISA, and supports the SV39 virtualization scheme. Includes a branch predictor with a return address stack. Pipelined IEEE 754 compliant single and double precision floating point units. Multi-channel direct memory access DMA support. Various peripherals like 2I2C, 2UART, 2QSPI, a JTAG debugger, a 256 kilobyte tightly coupled memory, 32-bit GPIOs, and an expansion bus that can be connected to an FPGA. This was taped out at SCL, which has been tested to operate at a frequency of up to 70 MHz. The area of the chip is 144 mm². This chip has been packaged on a 208-pin ceramic quad flat pack, CQFP package. SHAKTI Group has taped out 2 chips in 1 year.
With the advent of Digital India, there is a great need for making processors which can be amenable, which can be configurable, which can be customized for our country's need. We need to have complete independence in designing processor systems that we could use for any of our use, both civilian and strategic. With this idea in mind, the RISE Lab, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, IIT Madras, started an ambitious project as early as 2012 to basically design a processor that could be useful, that will be of commercial grade for the country. We had 2020 as a deadline for that. Around 2017, we basically got funding from the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, under which we are doing 2 processors. One is of the embedded class, which can be used for IoT type of applications, and another would be out of order super scalar class, which can be used for a basic building block for laptop, mobiles, etc.
This project was carried out in 3 phases. The first phase being design and verification. The design was done using a hardware description language called BlueSpec System Verilog. Again, the backend was also done by IIT Madras and SCL using commercial tools. This was really a great learning experience for me, as I got to work with the complete flow of the design, starting from the design phase to the backend to verification, tape out, and the board bring up. The design was completely done at RISE Lab IIT Madras, after which I went for an internship at SCL Chandigarh, where the backend activities was carried along with the help of SCL engineers. This, after the backend activities were performed, the resultant GDS was then sent out for fabrication, which was again done at the SCL fabrication facility at Chandigarh. We then received the packaged chips, which arrived here at IIT Madras. The board required to mount this chip was also designed by IIT Madras and manufactured at Bangalore. Once the board and the chip have been manufactured, we then assembled the components and then went ahead with the complete board testing. As you can see, this is the verification setup that we have. So this is the board that we have designed, plus the SCL chip that has been mounted on this socket. Also, we have connected an external FPGA board on which we have external memory, which is a high bandwidth memory, connected to our motherboard. In this particular testing. What we are running is a program called Paranoia, which tests the stability and correctness of the floating point unit that is put inside the processor.
What we have achieved in the last six months is that we have made two tapeouts or two chips that have been manufactured, one using 22 nanometer and the next one is a 180 nanometer done at our semiconductor complex, Chandigarh. So the 180 nanometer adds lot of significance because that really gives us complete independence, not only in the design, development, verification, prototyping, mask making of the processor, but also fabricating it within our shores, and also then the subsequent boot up and software development. What you would have witnessed in this video is the entire process of the development and then the software porting and running on the 180 nanometer chip that we are manufactured, and we are very proud that it has come out very successful, and we thank all the people who have contributed this, first to my team at the RISC lab here, and then to the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology who funded this project, and of course to the IIT Madras management for being completely supportive of these ventures.